Fear and faith cannot coexist. One gives way to the other. The simple fact is we need to constantly build faith and overcome sources of destructive disbelief. The Savior's teaching regarding faith as a grain of a mustard seed recognizes this reality. Consider it this way. Our net usable faith is what we have left to exercise after we subtract our sources of doubt and disbelief. You might ask yourself this question: is my own net faith positive or negative? If your faith exceeds your doubt and disbelief, the answer is likely yes. If you allow doubt and disbelief to control you, the answer might be no. We do have a choice. We get what we focus on consistently. Because there is an opposition in all things, there are forces that erode our faith. Some are the result of Satan's direct influence. But for others, we have no one but ourselves to blame. These stem from personal tendencies, attitudes, and habits we can learn to change. I refer to these influences as the six destructive D's. As I do, consider their influence on you or your children. First is doubt. Doubt is not a principle of the gospel. It does not come from the light of Christ or the influence of the Holy Ghost. Doubt is a negative emotion related to fear. It comes from a lack of confidence in oneself or abilities. It is inconsistent with our divine identity as children of God. Doubt leads to discouragement. Discouragement comes from missed expectations. Chronic discouragement leads to lower expectations, decreased effort, weakened desire, and greater difficulty feeling and following the Spirit. Discouragement and despair are the very antithesis of faith. Discouragement leads to distraction or a lack of focus. Distraction eliminates the very focus the eye of faith requires. Discouragement and distraction are two of Satan's most effective tools, but they are also bad habits. Distraction leads to a lack of diligence, a reduced commitment to remain true and faithful and to carry on through despite hardship and disappointment. Disappointment is an inevitable part of life, but it need not lead to doubt, discouragement, distraction, or a lack of diligence. If not reversed, this path ultimately leads to disobedience, which undermines the very basis of faith. So often the result is disbelief, the conscious or unconscious refusal to believe. Disbelief is the scriptural state of having chosen to harden one's heart. It is to be past feeling. These destructive deeds, doubt, discouragement, distraction, lack of diligence, disobedience, and disbelief all erode and destroy our faith. We can choose to avoid and overcome them. Challenging times require greater spiritual power. Consider carefully the Savior's promise. If ye will have faith in me, ye shall have power to do whatsoever thing is expedient in me.